So hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you is a NPTEL pattern, final exam pattern, that is a proctored exam. And I will also tell you my experience of writing NPTEL exam. So I've written three exams, okay, on three different topics. And I will also give you tips to how to pass this NPTEL exam very easily. So it's very simple to passing it. So this is what we are going to discuss in this video. So first, let me start with the exam that I completed long back ago. So I did this programming in Java. So it was one of the, it's a three credit actually, this one. So it has about 12 weeks of duration, so it's a very long course. So it basically contains topics from basic Java beginner level till it contains high end. So it contains like GUI and till that. So it's a programming course. So in this course, basically what you have is that, as you can see here, it has like ratio of three combined together. So the first 25% marks is done by using this assignment. So assignment is basically like this question. You will be knowing that you need to fill this MCQs, that stuff, okay? That is what the assignment. And another 25% is, by the non-proctored exam. So this is the non-proctored exam, is the exam that you write in your home. So this exam was like, so as you can see, this was a non-proctored exam. So yeah, they just asked, like they gave a question and they just asked some program, we need to type the program and run it, they done it, that's this thing. This is a non-proctored exam. You will need to write this non-proctored exam from home, and that non-proctored exam is also 25%. And the final exam, proctored exam, that you need to go to a center nearby your location. So that accounts for 50%. So it's 25, 25, 50. So passing is like you need to score 10, 10, and the final exam you need to score above greater than 40. So this is the pattern. So yeah, this is the criteria, and as you can see here, this exams. The exam's final pattern basically depends upon how the questions are asked in your assignment, okay? So this this Java course completely had MCQs. So in the final exam, basically I got around 50 MCQs, okay? So I got around 50 MCQs. So 50 MCQs. So 50 into 2, basically you will get 100. And this 100 was converted to 50. Okay, this is how it was done. So this is what Java, and how to pass is basically like, I would say that you need to basically read, study the assignments more importantly. So that's what you need to focus on. So as the, in that 50 questions, I nearly got around 15 to 20 questions from assignment. So these questions were not same questions, but they were similar. So many cases, the question was slightly modified and options were changed, and some questions were even the same from that. So 15 questions will be directly from the assignment. So you need to focus on assignment, okay? You need to just re-study all the assignment from week 1 to the end week. And the remaining 30 questions that I got was like from the videos only. So they are asking only from the videos. So basically what I would say is just watch a week full of videos and just write down in a notebook. It will be really useful in the form of some MCQs. It will be really useful at the end. So it's really impossible to study everything before the day. I would say before the day, basically you can just go through the assignment and go. It's better to study day week wise. So finish a week, then your job is done. So this is for programming in Java. And for many theory courses, like you don't have this programming stuff, that is this proctored exam, non-proctored exam at your home. So for you, it will be like 25% and 75% will be the last exam weightage, and that will 75% will also be MCQ. So I will show you another course. So this course is slightly different from programming Java, but it's also a programming course. It is programming data structures and algorithm by using Python. So I did this course, and this question also has the same criteria, okay? As you can see here, you need to score 40 and above, that is 10 out of 25, 25 and 50. So same thing as Java course, as I said you earlier, 25, 25 and 50. But the only thing different here was the pattern. So I wrote this exam actually before 2 days, okay? So the only thing that is different in this course was the pattern. So to be frank with you, this course had a quiz, okay? It didn't have assignment. It had assignment, but this assignment was only available for a few weeks. As you can see here, we had many quiz, and it was like shuffled. 1 week we had a quiz, 1 week an assignment. So this assignment was basically like a program, okay? The normal program. And this quiz, what, there was a twist in the quiz, okay? The quiz was in the type of MCQs. It was like Okay, you need to type the values in this. Okay, man. As you can see here, I have actually typed the value here. It's not an MCQ. Here also, I have typed the value. It's not an MCQ, but here is a MCQ. So it was like this shuffled with assignment and quizzes. In one question, you need to type the value, and in another question, you need to do this. Okay. And the question, you need to do the MCQ. So this was a very different in pattern. So and that's what I just told you earlier. The final exam pattern will depend upon your assignment and quizzes given to you. Okay, as a practice. Okay. So this the pattern for this exam was. I had about like 40 questions. Okay. This is why I'm saying for Python. Okay. I had like around 40 questions. And 15 questions were MCQ, and each question was 2.5 marks. Okay, 2.5 will into 40 will fetch you 100. Okay, 2.5 marks. And I had a first section. So every exam is divided into like sections 1, 2, 3. So the type of marks will be same thing, but the way of questioning and way of analyzing each question will divide the sections. Okay, that's the criteria of why they are dividing into sections. So 15 questions were MCQ, where I had options and the remaining 25 questions, there weren't any options. It was basically like they will give a program, they will get some ask questions based on the program, and you need to like print the output, find the error in which line, like that sort of. So there weren't any MCQs. There wasn't any MCQs. There was a box, and you need to just type the text string or text or a number there. So this was very hard to do basically. So you need to very much be careful while studying these kinds of exam, because in case of MCQ, you will have four options, and you will be like just aware. If you just go through the video randomly, you will be just aware. Oh, this is question corresponds to this answer. But in this case, it is really really hard. If you don't know the concepts clearly, you are going to suffer a lot in these cases, especially when there aren't any options to do. And I also did this Python for data science. Okay, this was very easy one. This was similar to Java. I had like 50 MCQs. Okay, and only thing, to be frank, you need to just watch the assignment question videos. That's only going to help you at the end of the day. And pattern completely depends upon how the questions are asked to you. So be very careful. In case they have asked like this, giving you a blank thing, you need to work harder in that case of topics or subjects. And this also had a proctored exam. That will be a very easy one. So that's it. I hope you will be clear with the pattern and how the questions are asked and how to pass in this NPTEL exam. So mine is a programming channel, and I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender, Unity, etc. So do check out my other videos of this channel and subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.